Hi guys, I'm Ruchi and I welcome you all to Mobisium. We have Redmi 5 with us, which was launched a few days back. And since we have had this device for quite some time now, in this video, we are gonna do a full review of Redmi 5. And Redmi 5 is a successor of Redmi 4, which was launched last year in the month of May. So today we're gonna see what all things this phone has to offer us and how is it better than its predecessor. So let us begin. But before that, I want you all to subscribe to Mobisium and also hit that bell icon so that you would know whenever we come up with a comparison video of this phone with all our Xiaomi devices which are in our drawer. So let us begin. Redmi 5 comes with the gold and black color variant. We have the black color because I love black, and also you get option for three memory based variants, in which one is 2GB RAM and 16GB internal storage, which would cost you ₹8,000. The other one is of 3GB RAM and 32GB internal storage, which we have with us right now, and it would cost you ₹9,000. We thought that the memory variant which we are getting for this price is the best suitable rather than opting for the cost clear one, that is 4GB RAM and 64GB internal storage variant, which would cost you ₹11,000. So let us begin by discussing the design and build quality of Redmi 5. To the back, we have the camera placed at the center, followed by the LED flash, and then we have the rear mounted fingerprint sensor. And if you have seen the Redmi Note 5 from our earlier videos, you would notice how Redmi 5 is similar to Redmi Note 5 from the design perspective. Like, everything else is similar, and what we feel is Redmi 5 is a clone of Redmi Note 5 in terms of design. So the device has a 5.7 inch screen with 2.5D curved edges. Display is an IPS LCD with Gorilla Glass protection. You get a resolution of 1440 by 720 pixels in an aspect ratio of 18:9. Device runs on the latest Snapdragon 450 chipset with 8 Cortex A53 cores, clocked at 1.8 GHz and the Adreno 506 GPU. You get the 3.5mm audio jack at the top, followed by the IR blaster. The right edge houses the volume rockers and power button. There are two vents at the bottom, out of which the right one is for the speaker and the left one is for the microphone. These vents have some kind of a mesh protection that prevents dust from getting inside. You also get a micro USB 2.0 port for charging the device, which is again placed at the bottom. The touch capacitive buttons have been traded for the on-screen button, but the fact that this thick bottom border is still there is kind of frustrating. On the rear, the device has a 12 megapixel camera with f2.2 aperture and a single LED flash. The front camera is a 5 megapixel shooter with f2.0 aperture that can record videos in 1080p, and you do get a soft LED flashlight for your selfies. You get a hybrid SIM slot and a fingerprint sensor that is mounted on the rear. The device has a 3300 mAh lithium polymer battery that is non-removable. The device has a metallic back and the edges are made up of strong plastic. These edges will be really helpful if you drop your phone, as they can impact and protect your device. The antenna design is something which you would see on every Xiaomi device, but I kind of like this design, like it gives it a decent look. Now I wanna talk about how the device feels, because the back of the phone is more about how it feels than how it looks, right? So this is one of those devices that have a very strange in hand feel. And to be honest, while I was using this phone, I felt like I'm holding a TV remote. And this is because the device is quite handy when it comes to its width. Like, you can easily wrap the device with just one hand. And also, all the credit goes to its 18:9 aspect ratio. So the device is fairly tall in length, so with these small hands I cannot simply reach all the parts of the device with one hand, and this is something which is eating me up for some time, but I'm also enjoying this 18:9 aspect ratio. Talking about the display in Redmi 5, we have a 5.7 inch IPS display with HD plus resolution and an aspect ratio of 18:9, like I said. The display is extremely good here. Like, the colors are very much alive. And also, when we were watching videos on this device, we found that there was an element of sharpness with the video playbacks. The brightness is also pretty good. Like, not the best out there, but it was pretty bright. And one thing I want to share is, if you watch videos on YouTube from this video, then most of them would be of 16:9 resolution. So there would be black borders around the videos. So what you have to do is you just have to pinch out to make the video fit to the screen. The auto brightness sensor is a little slow, and we often had problems changing places that had contrast in lighting conditions. So as they say that brightness delayed is brightness denied, the sensor works pretty well, but it is slow and it is not useful as of now. And that is the only complaint we have right now. Except for that, it does a neat job considering the price range. And so now let us move on to the camera performance of this phone. The device has a 12 megapixel rear camera with f2.2 aperture, and also we get LED flashlight. So let us look at some shots from the rear camera. These shots from the rear camera are very functional. Color capturing and reproduction is accurate, but there's no sharpness in the images. Also, even though the real colors are there, but the image quality is not that great. And you can see that the images pixelate as soon as you zoom in even a little bit. Also, as a whole, the images actually look lifeless. The HDR mode on this one was very tricky one. You can see these two images that we captured with and without the HDR mode. The HDR mode did some good corrections, but it wasn't perfect. You can see the strip of white in the corners of the blue sky. Now talking about the front camera, here we get a 5 megapixel shooter with f2.0 aperture and also a soft LED flash. The front camera selfies are not exactly bad, but they aren't good either. The images are okay, to be honest. There's no detailing in the images. Some front camera shots in the artificial lights are even worse, where the image isn't even clear without zooming. Lastly, the front camera can also record videos at a full 1080p. So let us have a look at the video samples from the front camera.
So hi guys, this is the front camera video sample from the Redmi 5. We are at this lake, so it's extremely windy over here. Also, there is a road on this side, so all the vehicles are going by. And I hope you guys can make out how much noise is being reduced. The video zoom is a little more than I anticipated. It's not too much, but it's a little more than I anticipated. So that's just about it. And back to the studios.
The video quality again is not so impressive. Noise reduction was also not good. I know the place was extremely noisy and still we could hear what he said, but the noise reduction could have been better at this price range. So we are extremely disappointed by the camera performance of this phone. And also I want to point out this thing that when we capture the image, it is not instant. Like, it takes approximately a full second to capture the image. Talking about the performance of this phone, here we get Snapdragon 450 processor, which is a successor to Snapdragon 435, which we had seen earlier in Redmi 4. This device has 8 cores or clocked at 1.8 GHz, and these cores are all based on Cortex A53, so they are low on resources as well. Here we get Adreno 506 GPU, which is an upgrade to 505 GPU, which we saw in Redmi 4 last year. So firstly, we have the benchmark scores from the N22 benchmark test. The device scores a total of around 70,000 on Antutu, which is approximately 14,000 points more than its predecessor, the Redmi 4. The new CPU in the Redmi 5 seems to be adding a lot of the overall score, since it is 7,000 points ahead of Redmi 4 along with the Adreno 506 GPU, which is approximately 2,500 points ahead of the Adreno 505 from the Redmi 5. We played the asphalted airborne on the device and it handled it like a pro. We were running it on the high graphics setting and the device gave us a smooth gameplay. I was expecting that the device would heat up with half an hour of gameplay, but that didn't happen. We will be doing a detailed review on its gaming performance, but I want you all to hit that bell icon so that you never miss any update from us. The device runs on Android Nougat version 7.1.2 and it gets Xiaomi's custom skin, that is MIUI version 9, with this device. The UI is dead simple and to the point. There's no app drawer like stock Android, so all the apps that are on your phone can be found on the home screen itself. Many of the basic apps have been provided by MIUI. You get a file manager, a music player, a notes taking app, and with the infrared sensor in the device, you also get a remote control app to control your devices that have infrared. There's no bloatware in the device and it is clean system. You get some of Microsoft's suite apps such as Word, Excel, PowerPoint, Outlook and Skype, but you can uninstall all of them if you don't like them. The device allows for a lot of customization with its inbuilt theme manager. You can choose from a wide variety of themes, wallpapers, ringtones, and fonts. You can even merge elements from different themes. There is this read mode which acts as a blue light filter and protects your eyes when using this device for longer hours in low light conditions. You also actually get the second space feature which acts like a second user account on your device. The dual apps feature lets you clone apps so you can run two instances of the same application at the same time. The one-handed mode lets you shrink the viewport of the device so you can use the device with just one hand. You can share files and apps with other users that have a Xiaomi device using MIDrop. There's an app called the Security Center that lets you control various security aspects of your phone and even clear junk files and scan your device for viruses. I actually am a big MIUI fan because I've been using it for quite some time now, and what I've noticed is they update their devices with the latest updates, and I think it is simply great to have so many features out of the box. Now talking about the battery life, here in Redmi 5 we get 3300 mAh of battery, which is slightly less than other Xiaomi phones which usually have around 4000 mAh of battery. I used this device for approximately 21 hours as you can see, and I was left with 8% of battery. I must have played games for at least 2 hours in total and had my music playing for some 3 to 4 hours on my headphones. The standby on this device was great. I think when I slept, the battery was around 62% and I woke up to a 60% battery, which is awesome. The screen on time was 8 hours, which is more than enough for a normal user for a day full of mixed usage. But do not expect anything more than a day from this device, and we will be doing few more detailed battery tests. If you want to see videos like these, then do hit me up in the comment section. Talking about some additional feature in this phone, we get an IR blaster with which you can control your infrared devices. Then we have the fingerprint sensor mounted on the rear end, which is quick as of now. But I have seen in other Xiaomi phones that it does slow down after some time. So let us see how it goes now. The volume levels on this device are louder than average, so it is loud enough. Also, the audio quality is great while making VoLTE calls. Microphone does a good noise cancellation, and also this phone doesn't heat up too much. Like, this is one good thing about this phone that is tolerant to heavy usage and does not heat up quickly. Also, when using your phones, I found out that this device outputs a slightly louder sound and I liked it. Now it's time for the verdict. So the Redmi 5 is a decent device with a great price point. Here we get good gaming performance, a decent battery life, great sound quality, and an average camera performance. Now the question is, should you buy this phone? I would suggest that you do not. I mean, this is a great device, but you have Redmi Note 5 out there in the market, which was launched a couple of weeks back. And for its 3GB variant, it would cost you ₹10,000, and I feel it is a great deal. Also, the 2GB variant of Redmi 5 should be ignored because it is getting a little tough to use 2GB of RAM even now, and after 6 months, it would be more difficult. So that was all we had, a little disappointment with the camera performance, so we won't be doing a detailed camera review of it, but we will soon be doing a gaming performance test, so stay tuned, subscribe to Mobisium, and also hit the bell icon. Leave a like, comment down if you have any queries. I'll meet you in the next video. Until then, stay tuned and stay happy.